Welcome to another Nature Discovery Screencast. Look over my shoulder and watch as I look for the pure beauty found in nature from the raw videos taken on one of my photo walks. The date of this photo walk was February 28, 2017, and it took place at a park in Cabarrus County, North Carolina, and that's in the United States. Let's take a peek at this raw footage now. Let's take a look at what we found on this photo walk. We have some beautiful spring flowers, some of the first. It's still winter time here in North Carolina, and these little beautiful flowers were some of the first to pop up and be seen on my photo walks. And this beautiful little set of flowers has a beautiful little beetle right in the middle of them here. And let's skim through and find out where we got the camera on the tripod. And looks like right about there. And I think the beetle is creating a new petal shape on this flower. And he's eating away there. He's just eating and eating and eating. You ever wonder how all those petals got so misformed? I think this is your answer. Beautiful flowers on a beautiful day here. A little bit windy. Creating videos, potential videos here for Final Cut Pro X. And the content gets put on Nature's Wild Things, a nature discovery website where you can search out and find the names of your favorite plants or birds that you've found. You just don't know what the name is. The website is designed for that. And not only does it show you pictures of the flowers and the birds and the bees, the insects, but it shows you these little insightful videos, so you can actually see a little bit about how that beetle acts and what it does to eat. And over time there may be other videos showing up of that same beetle doing different things, or the flowers in different settings and stuff. So it's a good nature discovery website. But we want to isolate out the good parts, the favorites here. We'll create an in there by pressing I on the keyboard. And we'll scrub through it. And we may be able to use that whole thing. And we hit F, and now we've created a favorite. And we can go back and look at just the favorites then. As you can see here, the down here at the bottom, the favorite is just that little piece we isolated out now. Let's go back to all the clips again. Click it, and let's take a look. We have another clip here of our flower. It's blowing in the wind a little bit. And just a different angle for that beautiful little beetle. Let's see, it really shakes around toward the end here. You can take some of the movement out with a stabilization on these Final Cut Pro X, but it has its limits. It degrades the picture some if it's moving around too much. So let's just call it a start and really start shaking right about there. Let's call that an out. Create a favorite there. Ah, the American Robin. Probably the most frequently seen bird in the region. That and mockingbirds. But the American Robin, like most of the places in the United States East Coast, I think, is they're just about everywhere. This beautiful bird, I believe, is a male. They say the male has that black cap on top of its head. It's got more of a black head compared to the rest of its body, the body being gray. And the females are more gray over the top of their heads. So it's hard to tell with the robins, but I think that's an indicator of the fact that this one's a male. And like all birds, they're ever vigilant, looking around. You can see this bird has a habit of holding its wings in that lower stowed position. I don't know what else to call it, but that's a trademark of the American Robin. Instead of having the wings folded back on its sides, it just kind of has them in a stowed position where they're lower than the contour of the body. And they're constantly on the ground looking for grubs and worms and bugs to eat. Right here he flies off. Let's see how much we can see of that. One big hop. And we're going through slow motion one frame at a time here. So it's as slow a motion as you can get. Take everything at 60 frames per second. So we get 60 shots of them per second. And off he goes. Well, the entire video is pretty good. The camera's moving all around though. So right about in here we get the camera stabilized. So we'll call that our favorite and move on. Now, just down the path a little bit, found this beautiful little green lizard. And we put everything on the Nature Discovery website with its complete name and its scientific Latin name. And this lizard, one of its things that it does that's impressive is it puffs itself full of air, I think, and puffs out like this. I don't know, without doing the research, what that's necessarily all about. I've not in the past been able to catch him when he's puffed out like that. And this particular time, he's already about finished the sequence that he goes through to get there and puffed out. So let's, he's out of focus there. The camera's getting stabilized. And he's starting right about there that it's in focus. So. And the entire sequence, the camera's kind of moving around. All sorts of bugs flying around them, and they're bug eaters primarily. Beautiful greenish color there. There's that little mosquito or a fly or a gnat or something flying around his head. Just keep that mosquito in there and call that a favorite. Next clip is just picking off where the last one left off. So this clip shows his movement. Just going through here a little bit slower rate. You can see on his underside, you can see him breathing. Movement a little bit with the camera, it's being handheld. That can be stabilized out. And there he gets ready to walk away a little bit. Let's just watch this in slow motion and see how he does it. Just front legs, hind legs, front legs, hind legs. Look at the toes that he's got there. Perfect for grasping, and the looks like little toenails that are perfect for just grabbing and wherever he's at and able to up and down and around. I'd say he's hunting is what he's doing here. Let's get a little bit of this sequence of him walking away until we lose frame there and call that our favorite. Now he's gotten this one. He's got his head behind the branch there. I believe he jumped. Not that we see it. Cameraman was standing on a bank of grass that sloped downwards, and it was very awkward with a three-legged tripod to try to stabilize it. Finding the nature gems amongst the cutting room floor collection is what we're doing here. And I'm not sure, he's a little darker green than he was just a few seconds ago or a minute ago. Nice little sequence where you can really see him breathing and his rib cage in there. Looking around, eyes moving independently. A little sequence. Got the camera a little more stabilized. He's not doing much here. He's kind of looking toward the ground with his eyes. I love the way his eyes swivel down. You get to see his coloring and the texture of the skin here and everything. They're all pretty stable, so we'll just include that as the favorite clip. Now he's moved, and so he's crawling down into the undergrowth here a little bit. See his movement, how he works his legs. I believe he's just, he's jumped over a little bit here. Oop, there he goes. Jumped right across there. So they're a jumping lizard, you might say. Get from point A to point B. So this little sequence allows you to see his underside of his head there a little bit in his neck area. I believe his ear is right behind his eye, that hole. Well, there he's puffing up for us. So the puffing up process seems to go backwards here a little bit. The puffing up process seems to include the warning that it's coming with his head being moved up and down. So I guess we'll go forward again here. I guess it's safe to say when you start to see the head pumping up and down, then out comes the chin. Very pretty. Have to do some research on this one to figure out how and why. Oh, there comes the tongue a little bit. Looking for ants or anything else that can be found to eat, I guess. Oh, there goes the head again. Here comes the chin again. Just a beautiful little sequence there. Skip ahead a little. There he's kind of looking down over the side, sure for something to eat. Little flies flying around his head again there. So I've got a sequence where, let's find an end point here. Although that sequence in itself, he's starting out with his head behind the grass. Now let's just start right there where the camera kind of finds him here. Let me see if there we go, right there. All right, I'll call that an in, and sequence kind of holds, goes in and out of focus once or twice. Don't know what we'd want to use out of that. Let's call that whole thing a favorite for now, and when we're editing we can figure out what's going on there and what we're going to use. We got the this clip here, we have the head starting to bob up and down. There it goes. And a couple of them, and out comes the chin. I'm sure there's a proper name for what that is. There's a proper reason for why he's doing it. I keep calling him a him. It could be a female, too. Without doing the research, just don't know much about it. Nature's Wild Things, though, is designed to help identify what you've got so you can do the research, so you know what to call it and know what to look up. Part of the problem with looking up all these beautiful creatures in nature is trying to figure out what its name is so you can at least find it. So it's hard to sometimes to describe a picture and come up with the backstory of what you're looking at. So that's a nice little sequence there. So let's call that about an out right there. Call that our favorite. Now, notice the really green color here. And just a few seconds later, in fact, you can see from the log that he's on and the branch going over. There's the log and the branch going over. The camera's a little situated, set up different. Like I said, we're on a grass bank that's sloping downhill, and real difficulty getting stabilized. But look at the difference in the color in just a few seconds. There's the other clip. Look at that beautiful green, and now look at the. He's turning brown, so he's changing colors with the environment right before our eyes here. Very interesting. lot of things to research on this beautiful little lizard here. What a color change. And that's a whole clip that is fairly decent. Now, in this clip, I believe he's moved just a little bit up the log. A fly flying around his head somewhere. I think it's just the shadow of the fly on his head there. I think he's getting browner. He's really starting to blend into his environment. We're taking minutes and minutes to go through all this, but the actual sequence time is about a minute and a half, I think, of discovering this lizard and following his habits here, what he does. I think what he's doing here, he's spotted something, a little ant or a little bug that's crawling on the log up out in front of him. He's got his eyes on him. Eyes are swiveled front. Go investigate here. Trying to move the camera. Figure out what he's going after here. Oop. Ah, behind a little branch. There was something there that he grabbed up with his tongue. Well, that's why we keep going out on photo walks, because we miss it sometimes and we get it the next. Yeah, it looks like he's got an ant in his mouth is what it is. Yeah. And it looks like he's discarded the hard part of the ant and just is eating the back end of the ant. Okay. Yeah, it's too bad that branch is in the way. You get to see his tongue there a little bit. This is why we call it the Nature Discovery Screencast, because we're out here discovering this nature together and the beauty of it all. Let's see what else he does here in this sequence. Behind the branch, but that head's starting to pump again. There it goes. 1, 2, 3. There it comes. Very interesting lizard here. It's kind of a long clip. The entire clip is almost 2 minutes long. And got some interesting sequences. I think the most interesting might be right in around here. The camera's moving big time. Stabilizing right about there. So let's go back, and even though it's behind the branch, we may be able to use it. And let's moves around too much here. Let's go right to about the point where he's done turning. For now, we'll call that our. All right, now we're turning our camera toward a small little stream here. Not too far away from where we found our lizard friend. And we have these beautiful little striped fish in the stream. Stream's not too big, so I suspect these fish don't get too large. There's no room for them to grow. And the stream, I'm sure, dries up quite a bit in dry spells. So I don't know what kind of fish these are. Let's find the sequence where the bigger one starts coming in. Although that's not too long a sequence, I don't think we have much to work with there. Let's call that an in there, and we'll call that an out. We'll see if we can do something with that then. If we need to start identifying and putting these fish on the Nature Discovered website here, Nature's Wild Things. Here, I believe they're all facing upstream. There, about there. And they're taking their turns going to the back. Okay. Now, one of the first wasps of the season is this beautiful little wasp with the red tail. This is the wasp you often see on the ground, and you'd think the wasp was blind because he really explores the world with those antennae of his. And the antennas have a predominant white stripe on them. But look how he explores his world. Those antennas are going and going and going. Again, I don't know the nature and the purpose behind what he's doing, but we're sure going to be able to identify this beautiful little wasp and use sequence like this on our website, so we can look for him, find him, identify him, and then do the research on all the other great resources on the internet. In the meantime, we can just observe nature there. And those antennas are just going and going and going. All right, so he kind of, camera's moving all around, but right in that sequence here, we can see those antennas working, right on up to about the end there. And we'll mark that as a favorite there. All right, now one of the first little spiders of the season. Still winter time. Still not many insects flying around, but we have a few small little spiders here. So small, in fact, that it's very hard to focus on them and hold that focus. Camera's always trying to autofocus on something, and when the object is so small, it's often trying to focus on something way in the background. So the difficulty with very small things is trying to maintain a focus. And sometimes one of the ways to get the camera to focus is to find something at the same distance close by. Let the camera focus and then move over to the object that you really want to focus on. And here you can see the camera's just trying, and there it's in focus. And we have our spider has pounced on what looks like one of those tiny little bees that fly around. And starting to wrap them up already so that the insect doesn't get away. Again, we'll need to identify what kind of spider this is here. And if we produce a video on him, we'll have to crop the entire thing a little bit so we can see a little closer up what's going on there. Can't crop too much because it degrades the picture a little bit. And there he's going off, climbing up his web. He's got his little package secure. Means he's got dinner figured out. And little leaf bud or blossom or something there caught in his web, blowing around, partially going to destroy his web if it gets windy. The wind's going to take that and destroy that little part of his web, but then they just go around and fix it. They're so small that he's going in and out of focus here now. Okay, now he's, what's he doing there? He's put his hind set of legs, or he's put his body down. I don't know what he's doing. It looked like he's raised his hind legs and he's just stowing them up, but the hind legs, I think, are on the web, and he's just holding his body down. So don't know what that, maybe that's his rest position. I'm not sure. All right, so let's take a look, and where do we start here? Right when he comes into focus, right about there, call that her in, let him crawl up to the top, start losing our focus, call that an out, call that a favorite. All right, we've taken another photo walk and narrowed down our favorites to use on Nature's Wild Things website, possibly sometime in the future. Till next time.